Hello, all. I want to quickly talk about the importance, the power, and the purpose of your inbox. Let's do it. Now, what is an inbox? Don't think of a physical tray to throw everything. Don't think of the inbox in your email either. Think of the inbox as the one trusted area in your life that you can dump anything, physical or non-physical, to sort it out later. What's the purpose of this? Why is it important? Let's talk about it. Ultimately, your inbox is there to be a catch-all. It is the one spot that you know you're going to check frequently, so it's a trusted system, and it's a spot that you know you can dump just about anything. Now, the great thing about having a one-stop place for all your things, whether they be, well, anything, is that, say you're walking down the street, realize, oh, you have to pick up groceries by a certain date, throw it in the inbox. Oh, you have to call your friend about some event, throw it in the inbox. Oh, there's a concert you want to see with your mom a few months from now, throw it in the inbox. Now, I know what you're thinking. We cannot maintain a system that just has hundreds and hundreds of inbox items. After a while, this is going to be the least comprehensive list of tasks and projects and whatnot ever. That is not the goal here. The goal is to have a trusted source of all the things you have to maintain. Now, what do I mean by this? Well, your inbox is very simply just the first stop in a long journey of multiple stops that a task has to go through to be properly organized, managed, and ultimately executed. Say we are having our nightly cup of coffee, it's around 6, 7 p.m. We look at the task manager, we say, oh, what's in the inbox for today? Let's look at the things that we recorded and jotted down throughout the day. Task number one, call a friend regarding hardcore metal concert that we want to go to next week. It's a little late in the day, maybe. You don't want to bother them during dinner time, so you have to do this task at some later date. And it's also really far out. You don't want to bother them with something that's not for a couple months from now, perhaps. You want to manage it. So you put it in your task manager under a project that has to do with maybe all the calls that you have to make. Maybe you have another project, or you contextualize your projects based on who you're calling. So if I have to call one certain person regarding this item, and I have a few other objects in my inbox that have to do with that same person, I'll group them all together and contextualize them for that one person. Another route you can take is just simply doing the thing altogether. Say one of your inbox items is to wish a dear friend happy birthday. You recorded this inbox item at the office in the middle of the day, but you didn't want to whip out your phone and start texting people. So you see it now, and you say to yourself, oh wow, that's gonna take 1 minute at most. So you shoot the text over, and you normally want to do the things immediately if they're only going to take 2 minutes or less, because that way it would take more time to actually manage the task, record it properly, organize it to when and where you have to do it, than it would be to just do it in the first place, right then and there. These are just some things that you can do with your inbox. The list goes on. You can throw in anything there. You can even put physical items in there if you have to. You can also put more events in there. You can keep your inbox as the one-stop place for all your things. Throw it in there, organize it later, get it off your mind, because if you don't get it off your mind and throw it in your inbox, you're going to be thinking about it all day, and it's going to bother you. You're not going to be able to get anything done. Inbox it.